Hello everyone, welcome to Basic Electronics Virtual Laboratory, and in today's tutorial we will learn the implementation of full wave rectifier. So just click on full wave rectification. As we all know that the rectifier is used to convert alternating current into direct current, and there are two types of rectifier, half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. And in full wave rectifier, first is center type and second is bridge type full wave rectifier. So by clicking on simulation, there are two types of experiments. First is full wave rectifier, in which circuit is already given, and in second experiment, first we have to draw or we have to complete the connection and then simulate the circuit. So just click on full wave rectifier given circuit. So this is bridge type full wave rectifier. On the left hand side there is a list of instructions which we have to follow for the implementation of full wave rectifier. So set the value of load resistance, click on on button, click on sine wave and then oscilloscope to see or to measure the output. We can vary the value of amplitude, frequency, volt per division with the help of different controllers that are given to us. So let's start the implementation or the simulation of full wave rectifier. First, set the value of load resistance. Then click on the button on. Then apply sine wave and then click on oscilloscope. So channel 1 is for input signal, so this is our sine wave. Channel 2 is for output, so this is the output of full wave rectifier. If we are interested to see both input and output, then click on dual. We can shift or change the position of input and output by clicking on these control buttons, and we can vary the time division with the help of this tab. So as we can see, this blue line representing the input signal and this brown color is for output. So the full wave rectifier is converting the negative half cycle of the sine wave into a positive half, and it is rectifying the alternating current into direct current. The peak current value with the help of this load resistance can be calculated. If we change the value of load resistance, this peak current will change. So with the help of this simulation, we can understand that how a bridge type full wave rectifier is used to convert an alternating current into a direct current. Thank you.